What's going on, y'all? We are back. We are finally back in the spot. It is definitely hotter than a motherfucker. I'm not talking about the Nelly song. I'm dying. Anyways, welcome to the spot, y'all. It's a Figure It Out podcast. We are here at the spot again. Happy to be here with my fellas. You know what I'm saying? We got my co-host, Turtle.
Exactly what they do, bro. Hope y'all got y'all masks. Please don't buy them. It's a little cheap inside out. So I'm tired of saying that. It's enough is enough.
All right, the soft-spoken assassin. And we got my boy, Terry.
Just live your life.
And I'm Brian G, y'all. All right. I just don't know what this nigga just gave me. But anyways. So, fellas, how much weight have you gained over the quarantine? Terry, that's not really a conversation for you. Turtle?
I ain't gonna lie, probably like maybe 5 pounds, that's it.
Okay, y'all skinny niggas.
I actually did gain a little bit.
Where? In your neck?
Gain is a gain, though.
In your neck?
That's like my accomplishment, man.
With me?
You know, you wouldn't guess like 20.
Wow, that's where we're going with this? That's 10. Where we're going. We went to 20.
10.
Wow, not even 5? I know I got titties, but that's how far.
I wasn't 5. 10.
I just feel like 10.
All right, y'all. So we're just going to go ahead and fast forward from that.
How much have you averaged spending food this whole coronavirus? We're going to calculate this right now.
First of all, everything been closed, so I ain't buying nothing during.
So how many times you cook a day?
I don't cook, so.
So what you been eating?
Hot Pockets. So how many Hot Pockets a day?
How many Pot Pies?
Toaster Strudels. I know you got some bacon spice, dog. I know.
I see y'all enjoying this.
Supreme.
Okay.
3 cheese.
All right. Oh, let me know when y'all done. Right. Next.
I think I'm done.
Okay. All right. Have any of y'all seen the barber? Receiving hairline ass niggas? Anyways, next.
I'm barber.
So, yeah, we see that. We see y'all own barber. Y'all been trying to cut y'all own hair. I went to a professional.
When your hairline's fucked up, it don't even matter.
How much you paid for that?
It don't even matter anymore.
More than you do for rent. Anyways, next. All right, y'all. So I see these ladies keep posting it. Ladies, we notice that you keep posting the take me back pics. And this is just from us coming to you. Nothing about today. No recent pics. I've seen all y'all just, I get y'all been eating on them quarantine snacks. So it's gonna be a hot girl love handle summer. Anybody else feel that way?
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
This is gonna be a Stairmaster summer.
I just wanna know if the sundress is gonna be a booty in the front and the back.
Of course, it might be on 3 dimensions.
I'm cool, because now we're even. We're all on a level playing field. I can get anybody I want right now. Everybody fat.
Ain't nothing wrong with it.
Everybody's fat.
As long as they pull it off.
It's winter soon, so it's like, might as well just wait. Then drop it.
All right, that kinda makes sense. So, fellas, I've just been noticing a lot of dudes, pause before I say this, but it seems like a lot of guys I thought were put together really just been drawing on their tape lines, and it's just like they a totally different person when they can't get all that stuff. I realize a lot of people, like, gotta get all this stuff done to them when these hair salons are closed, barbershops, all that. Like, you know that spray of tape on? You know what I'm saying? That spray of tape, when they spray that tape on.
Beijing?
Yeah.
Beijing, that's the name.
You see, yeah, whatever it is.
But he had
the permanent marker.
It was, yeah, the permanent marker. And he was like, oh yeah, I'm going out to the pool today. I don't care about no coronavirus. He was like, man, they wild out here. All of it just washed off.
I just don't know.
The side, to me, the side sticker and this was completely gone.
It just looks so bad because they look like the tip of a Sharpie and they don't realize, like, no hair is that black.
Yo, if the ladies can do it, why can't we?
I ain't gonna lie to y'all. When I get on,
that's not.
I'm gonna tell y'all right now, when I get on, and I'm just being real. It's gonna happen, but when speaking into existence, I'm buying a beer. I'm gonna buy a beer. Y'all look at me anytime y'all want. I had to shave my little coochie patch, but I'm buying a beer. Drake did it, so why can't I?
I can't angle out. I'm kind of with you on this, because like this, I feel like when I get money, I'm gonna do what Deion Sanders did. I need to adopt that Deion Sanders hairline.
Yeah.
Because you notice, like, he was bald for like 3 years and came back, perfect hairline, smiling. Just like, he was like, hey, I paid for it, so I'm gonna show it off.
That's crazy, and that's how I'm gonna be, because I'm not gonna lie about my beard. I'm gonna be like, yes, I paid for it. Yes, I'm gonna be honest. I'm probably gonna be paying for it in payments because I'm realistic. So I ain't gonna buy the beard like off rip, just drop the money on it. It's probably gonna be a payment plan.
So if you do a payment plan, it's gonna slowly grow like shade in. So
No. I'm gonna get the whole thing.
Oh,
I'm going full lumberjack. Like, bam.
What if you miss a payment? Do they like take a part of something that becomes patchy over time? Like, how does that work? Like, it's gonna be something.
I think you gotta miss like 3 payments before they just take it back.
I don't know. They gonna take it patch by patch? You think they gonna come and take it down to a goatee, and then before I know it, it's just a mustache?
Possibly.
Well, I don't think it will get to that point where they repone tapes. That's just crazy.
It's 2020, things probably.
So as the world's opening up, fellas, as we see the quarantine's ending, are you guys gonna go right back out there?
Nah, I ain't doing nothing until phase maybe 3 or 4.
Okay, so phase 3.
Wait, see what the other people do, what happened to them.
I'm gonna be honest, yeah. I'm gonna wait for that first batch of air to kill the first, first set of people.
I need to see how many people catch coronavirus the first time the office opens before I make my...
Oh, yeah. You know, I've been missing strip clubs.
Yeah,
I do not frequent those places.
I don't, but my food be so good that sometimes you get it to go.
That's all I go for. I go for the wings.
Like, if Uber Eats was at the one...
Have you ever had some strip club wings?
Yeah.
Strip club?
Yeah.
I thought you guys were talking about an office.
You're drunk, give me the keys.
Yeah, you're done. Well, anyway,
I don't.
So you're gonna act like you've never been there?
I don't do things like that. I'm a Christian man, sir.
Well, you do got a Looney Tunes shirt on. That screams virginity, so.
Yeah, yeah. That means this COVID hasn't affected you at all. You've been beating your meat like a mother, huh?
Hey, listen.
I would not want to hood.
Listen here.
Turtle, that's why I was gonna say pause. That's what you just
But you did
pause.
It.
I was going to. I had to sip my drink.
That was my pause.
Anyways, next.
So far,
I'm willing to throw some honorable mentions, because I'm willing to say like Da Baby, had a nice little album. Future had a good album.
I ain't gonna lie, I don't like Future because he didn't go through the heartbreak. I need heartbreak Future, but
you need Toxic Future.
Yeah, but I know that don't come out unless it's the mixtape. He's like how Lil Wayne is.
Yeah,
like,
you know what I'm saying?
The mixtape is here, but the album is like it goes anywhere between here and here. So
yeah, and not even that. I feel like sometimes Future recycles some stuff, but
yeah.
I mean, I think I'm honestly willing to agree with Lil Baby because Lil Baby stuff was hard. I mean, some of his stuff, and I don't really even like listening to him. I'm be honest. Like, that's not my speed.
It kind of feel like
I have nothing against him.
It showed, like, it's kind of like I was the same way, because I heard the first two albums, so I'm like, okay, it's going to be one of them. And then it's like, he showed, like, that change, that growth. So it's like, all right, so he went from here to here. Like, it's like kind of like the Baby did it different, but he came in hot. Like, remember the first two? It was
two albums. he hit us with two albums, like, bam, bam.
And
like,
he had like what, 8 songs on the radio at one point?
And I mean,
it kind of flipped. Now the Baby got like 5 now.
Yeah. So here's another question. What if one got to go? Let's say Lil Baby, the Baby, Drake, and Future out of their album.
Drake album was kind of all right. It wasn't great. It was all right.
Yeah,
it was all right. Because I feel like with Drake, I need Drake to get doubted for a long time and then come at us with some.
It's not even that. I feel like some artists is like that first album after Rust is gonna be like, it's gonna show.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's gonna be like, all right, it's there, but it's not there. Like,
that's true.
Like, you expect so much from, think about it. If he's like damn near a legend, if not a legend already. You can say probably a legend.
That's true.
Which, especially, he started the whole Canada wave, but it's just like, it's like you expect, let's like, what? Bring up Wayne again, even Future. Sometimes you expect here, and it's like,
But one gotta go though.
One gotta go. The Baby.
You gonna give me the baby?
Baby?
Yeah.
But you don't. But we just don't know how far, much farther he can go. You just
don't
know.
He's just beginning.
It's gonna be.
You gonna cut a baby at the legs?
Be lame,
he just started walking.
Gonna kick a baby.
More like the ankle, not the whole.
Turn you a savage.
Just.
What about you though?
Oh.
I don't hear that.
It's between the Baby and Future. Between those two. I just feel like with Future, we getting the same stuff over and over again.
You know what?
You know what? I want to change my answer to Future. Now.
No, you can't do that. You can't do that. You already said you're going to cut the Baby before his career even started.
You used to cheat on your test, huh?
No.
No,
you can't cheat on open book test. You can't cheat on open book
test. Well, that's not true. I did.
Just because your book was open don't mean it was open book.
I definitely Googled while it was open book.
Yo,
I have my
the
phone.
The world is your book, okay? The book is already open.
Didn't you hate when you used to? I used to hate when I used to be like trying to cheat with somebody, and I'm like, and then they put the paper on this side. Bitch, I can't read that shit.
Exactly. Well,
hand me the paper back.
You know what's
hand me the paper back so I can switch tests real quick. Let me copy my.
You know what's worse than that? When they got bad handwriting in the game.
Oh
the test.
Man.
Are they answers worse than yours?
No, not even that. The worst part is when they scare you. When they be looking at the teacher the whole time like this, and be like,
you be like, bro, chill, bro, chill, bro, chill, bro, chill, bro, chill.
Like, you hesitate, nigga, give me the paper.
I'm gonna push y'all on game right now. If you really wanna cheat, all you have to do is sit next to the smart left-handed person.
That's true. So, ladies, just let y'all know Terry cheats.
That black man do cheat.
Wow.
You ain't have to put me out there like that.
That's terrible.
You put yourself out there. You over here.
I don't mean that, ladies. Black men don't cheat. We don't do that.
You over here just giving out pro tips.
I was talking about tests.
What type of tests?
I don't cheat in life. You know, I'm an adult now.
But life is nothing but a test.
Well, guess what? I'm still taking that test because the test hasn't ended yet.
So you're still cheating?
Am I? If I was cheating, you think? I'll be here right now. I'll be on the beach somewhere.
Nah.
All right, now this is getting a little too deep. I don't know what y'all talking about.
That yellow tape still up.
I don't know what y'all talking about.
That yellow tape still up. You can't go out there. They're going to arrest you.
Uh-huh. You're going to go straight to jail.
They're going to put your handcuffs and just drown you.
They wouldn't arrest me because I'm cheating. They ain't going to catch me.
How would they not catch you?
Because he's cheating.
There you go.
I think that dropped because he was bullshit.
You know what?
That's why it happened.
I can't
that's why the drop happened, because that's bullshit you just said. That was God. Call him.
I know it's strange, but my brain's gone really insane.
Damn, man, this fat ass man, I forgot to pick me up again, bro. Damn, man, ain't forget to pull out my mama. Oh, dog, bro, I swear, man, this man always sleeping, bro. This man don't do nothing. Man, you left me. Oh my God. Son of Jesus, damn. What are you watching? What are you doing home so early? Look, your mother left me. She only been gone for 2 days, Daddy. I've just been so lonely.
Oh no.
I promise I'll never leave you ever at school again. Just, all right, take my hand. I promise. Just,
Dad, I'm not touching your hand, man.
Oh God. Listen, you touch my hand, you cut my hand, I'm gonna whoop your ass. How about that?
Yeah, y'all, so these Airbnbs, these house parties are going on. I mean, have any of y'all attended?
Ain't that one so good.
Turtle, what the hell?
Listen, I got tested, I'm negative, so I wear a mask, but I gotta be worried about it.
You negative, so risk it all.
Not risk it all, wear a mask, wear gloves.
Live your life.
Shit, I had a whole suit on, man. Hey, like, I put my paperwork
on. I'm not finished the rest of the show like this.
I put my paperwork online, I don't care.
Your paperwork online? Oh, you one of those. I'm clean, baby, I'm clean.
Nah, I ain't
I'm clean, those. I'm clean.
You got me that for COVID.
Yeah, so I got a question. How is it at the parties? Do everybody stay 6 feet or?
Oh, nah, this ass in your face.
Hey, when you get too crowded, leave, because ain't nobody trying to suffocate you.
Yeah, it's ass like, in the face.
At one point, you get so many people in one room, the AC does start working, so it's like, why be in there?
So that's a lot of people.
It's ass in the face.
That's crazy.
Nah, not in my face. I'm not getting pink eye.
You get pink eye from ass in your face? What?
Yeah.
The more you know, huh?
No.
You Kevin Gates ass niggas.
I ain't said that.
The booty warriors.
Nah.
Nah, that's fine. Booty eaters.
Nah.
We all grown. Somebody eating booty on this stage.
One out of every 3 men eat booty.
Somebody.
Yeah, that's it. It's
somebody.
So, why not me?
Yeah. I mean, I get you.
How will from Airbnb?
To eating ass.
To eating ass.
I mean, this is the conversations that we must have.
No,
I don't understand.
Have these conversations.
I'm just saying, you talk about booty and face and pink eye. Don't try and throw this on me. Don't do that.
How do you get from eye to mouth?
They both close. But they close in vicinity. Vicinity?
Oh, with a B?
Vicinity?
Wording is hard.
Whatever. Anyways. This brings us to our next segment, guys. Pack news and sports.
You're always late. I can't take you anymore. You have no more sick time. Oh, no, sick. Are you okay? You don't do your work. You can't everything late.
All right, guys, so reports have come in basically about Antarctica may house an alternative universe, like, slash reality. Apparently, like, they're hypothesizing that it basically it ages backwards in that reality or whatever. What are your guys' thoughts?
This is why the world, all the countries, you know, they all decided that, like, Antarctica is, like, free. Like, it's its own, like, nobody owns Antarctica. It's its own thing. So it's just like, if everybody decided we ain't fucking with this country, that should let you know everything. If Russia and China don't want to fuck with it, and Australia, you know it's all in Australia.
Well, if Russia don't want to fuck with it, we definitely should know. It has nothing to be
like, it's that's kind of scary. Like, what else is in there? Like, what else is there? And was this the north part of it or the south part of it?
It's Antarctica.
I'm not gonna lie, y'all not even a little bit curious?
No, I'm not curious.
I am, but it's like, okay, when you look at it, do you know what point of yourself you're looking at, or even if that even still is yourself anymore?
I'm sensing a lot of Caucasian right now. There's a lot of Caucasian force coming from here. Because no. I am not curious to go find out what's going on over there. That ain't got nothing to do with me.
Universe, this is not planets.
Yeah, this
you
is
said
not
planets. Okay, no, I'm not fucking.
You don't know if you go in that universe and you find out all them people are the age so backwards that they don't like people with shoes or something. Like, you don't know. I'm just saying something stupid. But what if
they
know?
Even have shoes? Maybe it never got invented.
Are we really talking about shoes right now?
Maybe they smart.
Who brought up shoes?
You.
I did. Nah, but honestly, anything y'all see in movies, this proves that later on down the road, they basically are conditioning us to like, all right, see, we showed you in a movie. We showed you. You know what I'm saying?
Wait,
so you shouldn't be shocked.
Who is we?
Wait. But what if this is like the butterfly effect? Well, if they do fuck up something there, something here gets fucked up.
Well, that's kind of messed up because I don't hope another Brian. I hope another Brian pulls out because I don't want a baby right now.
You may not have a baby.
I'm sorry, baby, if you see this.
You might not have a baby.
I love you. I just don't want a baby right now.
You might not have a baby. You might become a stepdad.
I'm not playing stepdaddy to nobody's jits.
Hey, you said another.
What do reality. I look like?
Oh, since so reality, go backwards.
Since we talk about going back in time, if y'all can go back in time to one point in y'all life and change it, what point in that point in your life would that be?
I got one. I mean, one time we used to do this competition because it's stupid and we were just dumb little kids. We used to throw rocks before a car passes and you had to basically clear the rock before it passes. Oh. And don't let it hit the windshield, right? Oh. So I'm the type of person, I got to up the ante. I don't know why. I picked up that big, you know them like little cornerstone things that be on people's driveways? I picked up a broken one and I said, I bet I clear this car. And I chucked it. And you know how you watch it in the movie? I was like, it's gonna make it. And then it just caught the end of the windshield. And guess who come out the car?
Your mom.
No, my principal of my school. I'm not even lying. Like, literally. Now my mama and my daddy come outside. So not only am I suspended, I'm getting my ass beat. It's bad. So, I mean, that's one thing I wish I could take back. That and jumping off the roof, because I thought I was Aladdin. And I got on a mattress, and I sung the whole New World song, but the mattress just fell on top of me. My homeboy jumped off before the mattress fell. But.
So out of everything you wish to take back, an ass whooping, and falling off the roof.
Yeah, there's a lot of things, but I don't want to do too much that affects my new reality.
Those are the main two.
Turtle.
I ain't gonna lie. I go back to my second year in college.
Yeah, I fucked off that.
Yeah, I fucked up ain't the word. I fucked up in so many ways.
This story could go anywhere. It's college.
I mean, actually going to class.
Anyways, Turtle just... Nigga, you could have fixed that yourself. That's not even something that happened that you could have undid. What the...
Not the classes, the labs. That's what I mean.
Turtle. No, that just meant you just going and sitting down.
No, I actually did the homework and everything. It's just the labs. I did everything but go to the labs because I had to work. I had to pay my way to college at one point.
You know what?
It was like, well, all right, you got to put your own bill. All right, so I got to go to work at night. All right, when I got to the lab? Okay, the lab is 7 to 9. What time got to work? 8.
Oh, that ain't going to happen. You made an executive decision, Turtle. I respect that.
I know, because I tried to do it and got late to work a couple times. So I was like, listen, you got one time. Let's go.
Hey, man. You got to choose between that grown man stuff.
You made it. That's all that matters.
It's that grown man stuff, and then, you know what I'm saying? It's regular stuff, bro. Sometimes you got to do some grown man stuff. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes the decision you make is good for the now, and you know what I'm saying? It just doesn't always match with the future, but everything always works itself out.
Oh, definitely.
You know what I'm saying?
It's just...
That's all. So we're going to move into Pack Sports. All right, guys. So basically, this brings us to our next topic, Pack Sports, one of my favorite segments. We're going to go ahead and talk about our Florida Zone NFL MVP, Lamar Jackson. He's been spotted working out with his top wide receiver, Marquise Brown. And they were running routes at our local park and stuff like that. And are you wondering, basically, guys, can he top his NFL MVP season that he had previously?
I feel like passing yards, yes. Passing wise, yes. Running, no. Because they're going to be ready for it. It's like everybody, they're going to load the box. They're going to spy on them. Like, you know they're going to do everything to stop him and make him beat his arm. It's kind of like how when Cam first started.
Yeah.
And then he run open. And it was like, okay, listen, he's going to make him beat his arm. He was through for like 4,000 or 5,000 yards his first year.
Definitely.
But I feel like, I ain't going to say 5,000. I say he's going to throw for like 35, maybe 4,000 yards. Probably 30, 32 touchdowns, maybe 5 interceptions, I say, because he ain't going to throw that much. But it's the one of the ones where he have like 10, 12 completions, but for like 200, 240, 3 touchdowns.
Okay. So basically you're saying he could top the season he had previously.
Yeah, but more passing, less rushing. Yes.
Okay. I believe that. I think even during this crisis, he's being able to develop some continuity with his receiver. I mean, and that's his top option. So.
And it's also luck, too, because think about it. I didn't even know Hollywood Brown. They called him that because he's from Hollywood. I'm like, okay, I guess.
I think those two can be a great tandem for moving.
Oh, they will. They definitely will.
Terry Neon.
I'm glad you asked.
Terry don't watch sports.
Because I don't know
Terry don't
shit about what y'all talking
she
about.
Don't, you don't know a goddamn thing.
So... yeah, I'm just gonna say.
I'm about to say Steve Harvey, nigga. You just gonna disagree.
I'm just gonna say yes.
Yes, okay, all right. So Terry is useless in this goddamn thing.
No sports, got it.
Anyways, Terry's not included in this. So I guess it's gonna be a conversation between me and you, Turtle. Cause this nigga
I jump in every now and then.
Oh, you jump in every now and then? Just when you hear a name, just go.
Look at that.
What ain't this jump full in. Of shit? The Terry is full of shit. Anyway, that's crazy.
Space Jam.
Also, I just wanna add, fellas, that our local very own Antonio Brown was spotted working out with him, the workout whore, apparently. Y'all think he can come back or no?
Honestly, I'm gonna say this. I feel like he hasn't been the same since Vontaze Burfict hit him. Remember when he like got him?
Yeah, I think he knocked the CTE in.
Yeah, like that was the tipping point, because that's when he started the blonde mustache, the Mr. Big Chest.
I don't even know what his hairstyle is. I don't even know what it is.
I don't care. I just feel like he just needs to get back on the field, because I thought he was going to be good with the Patriots, because like he wasn't doing nothing off the
yeah,
field.
Yeah, he did. He did score a touchdown.
So I'm just saying, but I thought like, because it was like, you ain't hear nothing, and you know, that's like, they don't play that. It's like, social media, delete that. Facebook, delete that.
But
your mom and Bill Belichick. That's it.
But the thing is, it's still Antonio Brown. I mean, I just feel bad that he's getting labeled as a team obliterator, like, you know, unfairly, like, you know, Terrell Owens.
But in person, he's like calm. Like, I seen him at Ventura. Like, he was just like with his.
He's a cool dude.
Yeah, he was with the baby mom and his kid. That was before he said no more white women.
Yeah.
But,
yeah,
know, he was out there with him. He had a dude following him with a camera, like a documentary. The whole time. That's fine.
I'm just hoping that he can get back in the game. That's what I'm hoping for. I
heard
that.
Russell Wilson won the one to be on the Seahawks, too.
Well, we just going if he can get over there, maybe. If he can, I would agree.
Russell Wilson, you think they're going to tell him no?
I mean, no, because he's one of the highest paid, quarterbacks.
They'll get Josh Gordon. You think they're going to get Antonio Brown?
I would take, honestly, at this point, I would take Josh Gordon over Antonio Brown just because of the off-field issues. I'm one of those people where I don't believe that all field things.
But he's so deep in the substance abuse program that if he used mouthwash wrong, he's gonna test positive. And that's it.
Turtle.
He'll get Martavis Bryant.
Anyways, we're gonna
go to the truth though.
I wanna continue into the sports segment since Turtle, you wanna talk about people testing positive.
Antonio Brown.
Man's not in jail, Turtle. This man talking like he in prison, like he see murder. Anyways, we're going to move on, fellas, to Dak Prescott, one of the most controversial quarterbacks apparently right now. Why do you think he hasn't got paid yet? Rumors are saying that he wants $40 million plus a year, and his fifth year he wants $45 plus million.
Why are you looking at
Terry? I don't even know why.
Now,
it's just a natural thing.
Money? I can talk about.
Terry can talk about money.
Let's do this.
But you can't talk about football money.
Hey, money is money.
You gotta know the word.
Money is money, Turtle.
Money is money.
One thing I will want to add with this, guys, is I actually looked up the top 5 paid quarterbacks right now. Now, Dak Prescott is asking for $40 million a year. Now, the top 5 right now are Russell Wilson at $35 million, Ben Roethlisberger at $34 million, Aaron Rodgers at $33.5 million. You have Jared Goff at $33.5 million. And you have Kirk Cousins at $33 million. So why can't Dak Prescott get $40 million? Now, do I think he's better than Russell Wilson? I don't know.
$30 million. That's it.
30 million?
30 to 33.
But inflation, 30 to 33. Turtle. Inflation.
Inflation for what?
What you mean?
Okay, I
put would you want to get paid for a job that's literally $15 an hour, but you're doing $30 an hour work?
No, but this is the thing. If you're not doing $30 an hour work,
it doesn't matter, Turtle. If you're doing the same job somebody's doing in Minnesota, it doesn't matter. If it's $30 an hour as a job.
Minnesota goes wrong with it. Two times in a row.
All I'm saying is whatever the base salary is, you gotta respect that. You cannot pay the man on what you think he should get paid.
30's the base.
Nah, because inflation. Inflation is just, okay, it's just okay, gonna go.
Alright, match your question. Besides the people you just named and that, who else would be worth the $30 to $40 million range? Quarterback. Off the top of your head you can think of.
$40 million, I mean definitely Patrick Mahomes.
Well, okay.
He won a Super Bowl.
All right, besides him and Lamar Jackson.
I mean, you could argue Deshaun Watson.
Okay, I give you that. That was a...
Yeah, I mean, we talking sports. This is not Eric.
But you know, that's not mine.
I don't understand all about that. I'm talking about...
Okay.
Respect yours. Right. I mean, Terry, wait, he ain't there. Anyway.
All right, because... All right.
You gonna respect me. You gonna respect me.
Shut up when grown folks talk.
You got a little sports,
so
you got
a
Space Jam shirt.
Hey, listen.
Oh, my God. That's right. He do got a Space Jam shirt on.
This is more than sports.
Where Jordan and then Billy Crystal at? Or Bill Murray, I'm sorry.
They
wasn't the star.
Yes, they were.
These were the stars for the movie.
Jesus. This what man don't even know who in that movie. All right, fellas. This brings us to our fourth segment, our red button topics.
Okay, y'all boys, we have to do the last segment of the day, and that is the red button topic. And we have to go and talk about my boy George Floyd and how he was killed, and that evokes riots. It started as riot, and it evoked so many riots now coming across the country. I, for one, feel like it's about time. This is what we needed to do in order for them to start feeling like they should walk on eggshells around us, because they started treating us as if we weren't nothing and they could just do whatever they wanted and they had no repercussions. But now we have to show them, and we finally doing it. So I'm all for it. What about y'all boys?
I mean, me personally, coming from somebody that's actually experienced police brutality and has witnessed it, I'm a little conflicted. A part of me just feels like, basically, when I got into my thing, people said, oh, why are you wearing like what I'm wearing right now? But then I've been attacked by police and had police brutality when I've gone to work in my work clothes. So me personally, I just, the burning down and all that stuff, I get it. You got to burn down what they value, because all the peaceful protests and everything that we've done with Martin Luther King, it hasn't worked out. You know, there's no results for that, really, because we're still in the same. There's no reason why a Malcolm X speech should match the problems of today. There's no reason why a Tupac interview should match the issues of today. But that's just the world we live in. But yeah. I just don't see burning everything down. But I get it. You got to burn down what they value, you know, because right now they're dehumanizing us. But I mean, that's just where I'm at with it. I support everybody that's doing it, you know, but just do it for the right reasons and just don't destroy your own community. Just destroy it. To me, destroy the gentrification. That's the way I feel. You know, but I'm just different. I'm a rebel. Turtle.
I'm kind of in the middle, because I feel like the energy and response is correct, but it's misguided, because I feel like for every person that feels like they want to lash out and do something towards something, just destroy property or something like that, that's the person that feel like, I want to go be in law enforcement, to be in politics, and anything like that. Like, think about it, Trayvon Martin's mom is running for something in local politics. And it's just like, we need a balance of both, unfortunately. Like, you can't have good without bad. So it's like, for every, like, how whatever's happening now with the riots and everything, it's like, yes, it's, I understand it, but it's just like, Killer Mike said itself, like, you need to be able to take the energy and just plan, plot, strategize, and execute what you want to do. But it's just, destroying everything isn't going to matter, because all they're going to do is take that and build into something even better. And that can be used something that's, you know, detrimental and something that can help. So it's just like I said, I'm kind of middle. It's just like, yeah, like, lash up, because it's always been started for this long, because even before Floyd, like, it's like so many names you can name since, like, what, 2010? Even probably before that, it's been instances, but it's just like how Will Smith said, racism is not, it's not hidden, it's just being filmed now. It's like, with social media and cell phones, like, we're hearing about it more and more and more and more. And it's just like, it's something to where it's like, it's inciting people. Now it's not like it's, oh, some weird conspiracy theory about this and that and third. It's more like, you see it's something that's like a genuine hate. And you gotta fight or figure out a way on both ends to extinguish it. Because think about it, when you kill a fire, you gotta suffocate the source. That'll mean you go from one side, you gotta smother the source. So it's just like, you need some of every part of it, from every good idea from every side, and use that together. But it's just, everybody's acting off emotion, which I'm not saying nothing wrong with that. I can't sit here and say I got the best plan for this shit. I don't know. It's something that, like, it bothers me, and it's just kind of weird because I look at it from two sides, because my mother's in law enforcement. Then again, it's like, I've experienced getting pulled over by cops, getting guns pulled on, getting snatched out of a car, and then car stolen. And I've seen it to where it happened to my own mother, where, like, a cop pulling over and she'd be like, are you serious right now? Do you not know who I am? And she'll show me, you know, her ID, but she'll show her badge as well with it. And then it's like, oh, I'm sorry, man. Go on. But it's just like, for some reason, being dark skinned, black, African, or whatever you want to call it, having this skin color is like basically having a target on your back and being hunted. And the frustrating part is you have half that want to fight back and half that want to run. And you yourself kind of think, okay, do I run with them, or do I stand with them and fight? And it's just you trying to find that balance, because think about it. My thing is, every day, everybody deserves to go home. Everybody, no matter what you do for a living, or if you just leave the house and go do whatever. And it's just like, when that becomes an issue, when you can't do a daily task or something like that happen, it's just like, it's one of those things where you got to look at yourself, not even just as a person, but morally, and what you stand by, what you stand for. And it's just, that's some of the things where I say I feel like I'm kind of committed. Like, I feel like I need both. But that's just my opinion.
Yeah. Well, we need both, but at the same time, I'm telling you, it's something that has to be done. And I feel like that's consequences. There has to be consequences to what they have done to us. Because since they have done what they have been doing for so long, and there haven't really been any consequences, there hasn't really been anything other than a police officer kills somebody, they get moved over to another precinct and start getting paid again.
Definitely. But then even some of those, like I said, some of those cops ain't even safe. Like the cop that got killed by other officers in his precincts, and they claim they never knew him, but they worked in the same unit as him. So it's just, it's like, it kind of doesn't matter. It's literally just whatever your skin color is. If you're black, whatever, you're a target, whatever. That's literally what is your occupation, except for the one, another time where I know a state prosecutor got pulled over by a cop. And it was just like, she looked at him like, you really doing this right now? Do you not know who I am? So it's just like, until it's like somebody, we can get one of us to consistently hold a higher office, we have a voice, but we don't have a voice. It's like, now everybody's entertaining our voices for their game. And it's just like, where's the gym? The ones that are for us. It's not too many. Like, we need more people that's gonna be for that.
I personally just feel like I understand both sides. I understand the people that don't want to be in it. I understand the people who just ignore it. But right now, we need all those people. The people who ignore it. The people who just feel like, oh, well, what were you doing? Or, oh, what is his record? We just don't need to worry about all that. Right now, a man got murdered. More of us are being murdered. It's just, right now, I can see where people are saying, hey, we need people in office. Yeah, we need people in office, but we also need the way a black person's life looks needs to be valued as the same as everyone else's life. It needs to be the same. But I mean, we could talk all day about this, but right now we just need change. Definitely. I just honestly believe that we just need change. Definitely. We need real change. We don't need fake change. We don't need this being blown under the rug. We don't need, okay, we charge the officers, so everybody just go home. No, we need real change. We need real we need real consequences for everybody. You take a life, you lose a life. You want me to give it to you blood raw? That's just how it is. You take a life, if you feel the game, if you feel like you can take a life, you lose your life. And until they feel like that, that's when everything will be stopped. Until black life is valued as much as that.
Is it definitely in Minnesota?
I don't know, but if it is, y'all know what y'all have to do. But, yeah.
I know the lady officer that killed in our apartment, you know that she can get out in 2 years.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a sad world we live in, but I just want to say a special shout out, guys, to our sponsors. The Spot, of course, if y'all can't see it, check out The Spot Wynwood. It's a spot for local artists everywhere. People like me, they got comics, they got everybody. Shout out to The Spot. Shout out to New Age Society. You know what I'm saying? Check them out. Like, just, you know, we're just a thing. And especially shout out to Pack Entertainment. My people, where we come from, you know what I'm saying? Where I originate at, where we shoot skits. And anybody else want to give a special shout out? Any IGs you guys want
to
throw out?
Yeah, definitely. Shout out to me, because I didn't get here without being a retired person I am. So, you know, ain't me. Yeah, you know, but me, Twitter, Turtle33169, Instagram, Turtle305, that is O as in lowercase O, 5.
Yeah. Shout out to my mom. Wouldn't be here without you. Shout out to all my haters.
Who hates you?
And
that's a question.
You can find me at Terry Lamar.
You build like a
sport. Appreciate it.
Alright, y'all. You can follow me at Brian G Comedy. You can find me at anywhere. You can find me. Just look me up, alright? And most importantly, thank you for watching another episode. Thank you for The Spot. Thank you for everybody that's here. Shout out to our team. And most importantly, wash your ass.